Hello everyone. Today I am going to make a t-shirt design like this. This was a request, so I am going to show you guys how to make this kind of designs. And another reason that I am making this video is sometimes we get this kind of works. Maybe your client can send you an example and he maybe wants to make a similar or a better version of any existing design. So how to make this kind of designs? Before starting the design process, we need some elements like the mountains and the trees you can see in the background, and then these circular shapes we will create them. But the mountains and trees, we need to take them. So I'm going to use this social distancing. I made a design on social distancing and I give you this vector pack, guys. So I'm going to use these two vector for my this design here. So for making this kind of designs, first of all we need to understand that how to start the design process. So first of all we need to extract some colors from the original design. Like you can see these colors. If anyone, your client or anyone, is giving you an example like this, then your design should be also in similar color styles. But as this is a existing design, this is already maybe selling well or looking good, that's why your client wants to make a version of this design, and we cannot just create a same design like this. So we need to add some of our twist in the design, so make it a unique and better design. So for that we need to extract the colors. So I'm going to create three rectangles here. Then I am going to select these colors from here. Okay, as you can see, these colors are not looking very similar to these colors. And also this design is on a mock-up, like on a t-shirt. So these colors are looking a bit dim like this. But if you use this color, it will look like a little bit more darker than the original design. So that will not look good. So first of all we need to change the color contrast here. Maybe something it a little brighter than the original color that we extracted, and this is how your design will look good. We need to keep a very similar color theme but in a brighter version. As you can see, these are the similar colors but in brighter option, so we will use them in our design. So first of all I am going to add them in my source panel like this. Click on this create new color group icon. It will create a group in the source panel. Then I don't need this rectangles here anymore. So for this kind of designs, we need to first of all make these circles here. As you can see, this is looking very easy, but creating this kind of circles are not very easy, and that's why I get this request. If it was a very easy to create, then nobody would ask me to do that. So for making this kind of designs, first of all we need a ellipse like this. So there is no doubt that it is made with the ellipse, but how to like distribute the space in the keeping them in same size but keeping same space between them, that is really hard to make. So I'm pressing shift X to convert it into a stroke color. You can see here no fill, only red strokes. I will change the stroke colors, but first of all I need to make it really bigger. So something maybe 250 point, you can see here that is the stroke size I have right now. Then how can I make another version like this? If I select this one, press Ctrl C to copy, then press Ctrl F to paste, I can paste it like that. I can make it bigger. Then I can use my eyedropper to click here. It will sample that same color, like the same stroke size. But that is really hard to keep the distance same and then make another copy of this one. Ctrl C, Ctrl F. If I make it a bit bigger, then I can simply again pick my eyedropper to make it same stroke size, just like this. Sorry for that. So this is one way of making this kind of circles, and this is really a bit harder because it will not always work same. So there is another way of making this kind of circles. I'm going to show you that one also. So once we have a ellipse like this only in a stroke mode, we need to select it. But before selecting that, we need to know the point size, that is 250 points. That is good. So when our ellipse is selected, I'm going to make an offset path for my ellipse just like this. Then I need to make it the same size, like the offset path should be also in that size or maybe just a little bit bigger. So whatever size you are going to take here, like maybe 350 pixel, and press OK. So this is the same size in the, you can see this stroke is 250 pixel, this one is also 250 pixel, but the space between them will remain same every time. So I am selecting the outer ellipse here, then go to offset path, sorry, object path, offset path, then again the 350 pixel, it will create another ellipse for us. Then when our outer ellipse is selected, we can create another ellipse here, that same size stroke. So it will keep the everything in same size and the distance between them in same size. That is good for us. Then offset path again 350 pixel. Okay, so this is how we can make this kind of ellipse. But as you can see, this is not looking very interesting right now, but I will do something else here to make it look beautiful, just like this one. So as this is a design, they are using three ellipses here, we cannot make a similar design here. We need to make something else or something different or unique. So I am going to use some more ellipses like this. And for the colors here, okay, I made a mistake by erasing those colors. I need them right now. So I am erasing some like rectangles here to pick the colors. Then this one should be orange. So once our these three rectangle is selected, I'm placing them just like this, align them, then distribute the space between them. Now I need to go to object, blend and make. You can see it is blending these three color, like from the red to orange, then orange to yellow. But we need to fix that. If I double click here, it will bring up the blend option tool here. Then from this smooth colors, we need to make it specified steps. And with the preview checked, we can reduce the amount here. Like how many ellipses we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 rectangle will work for us. So once it is good, I am pressing OK. And that is the 5 rectangle for us. I am going to expand it, because whenever we are applying any effect, we need to expand that. Now as you can see, these are 5 separate color blocks. So that is making it the transition from the red to yellow, then in the middle orange. Okay, so I need to select my this ellipse from this area, then I can simply expand them to make them feel color. They were in a stroke color, so I am making them feel. Then for this one here, I am going to press I for eyedropper, then click here to sample that color, then pressing V for selection tool, select this one, press I to sample this color, press V to select, I, V, I. So that is how you can see how easily we made a smooth transition of the colors here. And for this one here, as this is going to be the center point, I am pressing Shift M for shape builder, then if I click here or maybe drag them like this, it will make it a complete ellipse here, not a like no space in that in between. So it is a complete ellipse now. Now I'm pressing Ctrl G for grouping it. So guys, this is going to be the background for my design here. Then I will add this text here or maybe some other text, but we need to make this background, this mountain shapes background. So let's work on that. This is a tree and this is the mountain. As you can see, if I bring this mountain here, you can see there are some white parts in your design. So I need to simply click here, it will select all the whites, then cut it. Then I am going to select my this mountain shape like this. As you can see, there are too many small parts, so I am making unite to make it a complete one shape. Then I am opening the transparency for it to paste the white that we take from the mountain. So paste in front. This is looking like this right now, but we need to make it black, because whatever we want to place in the transparency, it should be in black. So as you can see, this is the white parts. When we make that black and press OK, click here, and then if I select my mountain, I can change it to any color I want, and it will remain like the same details like before. So that is good for us. Now as you can see, they are using a very similar mountains like this, so we need to just make a like some copies for our mountains, just like this. Maybe this one a bit bigger in size than this one here in this area, maybe. Then maybe this one again here in this area, but a bit smaller than this one. So this is how my mountains are going to look. So I'm going to select that one, cut, paste in front, because I want to keep this mountain on top of everyone, then this one on the bottom, then this one on the, like this one is the last part of my mountains here. So for making them look realistic, I need to do some transparency work here. So I'm selecting my this mountain, as this is the top mountain for me. Okay, before that I need to select them all. Then if I click here, it will align them like in bottom. So I need to select my this mountain, go to object path and offset path to create a transparency. But as you can see, we used this mass effect, so let me make it 10 pixel. So 10 pixel is looking good for me. Maybe 15 pixel will look better. Yes, that is good. So let's cut it. Now I need to place that offset path in the transparency of this mountain and this mountain. So I can do it separately, like open transparency for this one, then this one, but or I can simply select this one and this one, make them a group, then I can open the transparency together. Then I can press Ctrl F to paste in front that mountain shape. As you can see, this area is not looking very good. Okay, that is the bottom of this mountain, so that will be fixed. No problem. So this is looking like this. Now I need to select this one, this mountain here. Then I need to make the offset path again, that 15 point is good. Cut it. Then I need to select my this mountain here. Now inside the transparency, press Ctrl F to paste in front. So as you can see, this is how it is looking right now. This is how my mountains are going to look. And they are using some trees to make it look like some trees in the mountain. So we can simply use some trees like this just to follow their style. Maybe this one like this, or a bit smaller in size, just to give it a feel like these are the trees of the this is a forest kind of mountain. So that is something like that. Okay, when our tree is placed, we need to select them together, because I want to place them in the background, or maybe just make it a group like this. We will fix that later. And this area is looking like too much flat in here, so I can simply select one of these trees, copy this one, paste it here like this. Then I am going to make it a bit bigger in size. Just like, okay, not bigger, in a smaller size. So I'm going to maybe place on tree here, so that it make a hard end at this point, so that will look good for me, because this area is the end of the mountains and that should be closed. That will look good. So that is good for me. Now I'm going to select my these trees here, maybe just like this. Press Ctrl D for duplicating the trees like this, then select them, align them center wise like this, so that it makes a like this hard end, it makes it looks like disappearing with the horizon here. So it will look good once my design is complete. So I'm placing them just like this. Okay, I think that is a huge amount of vectors in the design that will make it a heavy file. So let's align them together, cut them. Now if I select my these mountain groups like these four mountains, then make them a, okay, I need to select it, make them a group. If I open the transparency for them, I can paste in front, Control F, it will make this area look like this. But this is looking like too much artificial, as you can see, like everything here is in same size. So I need to fix that. Maybe some trees I need to make them bigger, not everyone in same size, bigger, just small and bigger, to make it feel like, so give it a feel like this is the natural tree areas. That is, I think that will work for us. Okay, this area is like, okay, now once our mountain is positioned like this, I have to select these tree groups, because you can see there is a tons of vectors here. We cannot keep them as they are, otherwise it will be a heavy design and it will be hard for us to work. So I am pressing Shift E for my eraser tool here, Shift E, and with my eraser tool, if I press Alt, then I can simply create a rectangle like this to erase the lower part of my trees that I don't need. And once I will erase those part, it will make it like, it will keep the only the top parts of my trees, and that is what I need. So my graphics will be like less heavier, and it will be easier for me to work with them. So this is going to take some time, guys. Okay guys, so as you can see, this is now looking like this, and this is good for me. And this area is only, I have this top of this trees and the bottom part is erased. That is good. Now if I turn off the transparency, I have this graphics like this, and I need to make them a group like this so that I can place them in the middle area of my mountains like this, then maybe in a bit bigger in size. So that is good for me. Now I need to select them. So my ellipse group and my mountains group, then align them together. Now for this one here, I need to place my mountains like this is the bigger mountain, so I want to keep that in the middle position just like this, so that this yellow rectangle, yellow ellipse that looks like or works like a sun there. So that is the main point for me. Now once my design is placed in the position where I want it, I have to just keep in mind that it is covering the side area of my design, and that is good. So once that is looking like that, I need to now select my this tree group, then cut this group. If I select my this group here, this ellipse group, I can open the transparency, paste in front. So these trees are actually going to work on the background of my mountains, so they are not a part of my mountains here. And for this one here, okay, I need to click here to come to the surface layer. Now I need to select this tree here, as this is the last position of my graphics here with the circle. So I need to keep that like that, place it like in the position. Then I need to make it, okay, I can simply erase this one, then select this one, make a copy here. It will keep them both in same size, align them in the bottom. That is good. Now as you can see, this is how it is looking, but I need to select this one. Okay, maybe I need to make this one a bit bigger in size, because, okay, sorry for that. I am keeping this as it is right now. So I need to make a offset path for my mountains here. As you can see, this area here, the mountains are not matching with the background here. There is some offset path area that is making it a different part of the design. So that is the effect I need to make here. So I am selecting my mountain group, then go to offset path, make a again the same size 15 point offset path for us. Okay, that is what I was talking, that if we put a lots of graphics in there, it will cause us some trouble. So that is now looking good for us. Then cut this one. Then I need to select this ellipse group here. Into the transparency, press Ctrl F to paste in front. Now guys, as you can see, this is looking like our mountain is on top, visible, everything is okay. And we need to erase this part of the ellipse here, the ellipse group here. Now we can simply draw a rectangle here like this one, a black rectangle to hide that part, or we can erase that part. But I think erasing is the best option for this part here, because if I keep everything like this using transparency, it will become a very huge file size. So I am going to select my ellipse group here, press Shift E for eraser. Now I am going to erase it like this, and as you can see, this is now looking like this area is erased. And the okay, for this one here, I need to fix the tree position. You can see this tree group, I need to now ungroup them. And as I pasted them inside the transparency, I can always make changes to them, like this one here. This is up to you guys, how you want to make your design. Just like this, I am placing a couple of some more copies of the trees here, just to give it a feel like this is a mountain kind of shapes. And that is actually good for me guys, my final graphic is ready here. But as you can see, we can see some problems in this area. So I need to select my mountain group here, only this four mountain group. Then inside the transparency where we pasted these tree groups, we need to do some works here. So I'm going to select my pencil tool. With the black fill, I need to draw some areas like this, and it will hide those part, these small details, because I don't want them to be visible. I want to make there a smooth cut, not a hard cut horizon. That is the reason I am making this one like this. So this is good for me, that is all set. My graphic is ready here. Then I can simply select this mountain shape, or maybe I can select my magic wand tool to click on this black color. It will select everything that is in black. Then if I take my eyedropper, then I can simply take maybe this color, or maybe a darker version to make it a colorful design, just like this. Or I can use this kind of colors, some colors like that. So let's select again this one. Okay, before that we need to go back when it was black like this. Then if I select this black, I can simply press I for eyedropper to sample this color from here. But I want to take this colors a bit lighter version, just like this, so that it doesn't look very dull. So that is the final graphics for us guys in this video. Let's add some text here. So okay, someone was asking for the font name. This font name is Stencil Land. You will find this one on thefont.com, but I am not going to use this one here. So let's use something like Outdoor Adventure. This is going to be the text for us here. Now this one here, I am going to make this adventure as something like a bit bolder font, just like this, because I like this kind of font for the adventure text. That is good for us, good for me here, just like this. Then maybe this one, maybe something, I don't know which one will look good. Hunter's a font I have. Okay, let me use something, some font that everyone have. like maybe any door, but not in that, not in capital letters, just like this. Okay, that is now my plan is changing. So let's make this outdoor in like that font, just like this. Then add this adventure in like maybe any dot text, but not like that, just like this. Then maybe, okay, that font is not looking good. I have another font, Arrow Kids. Okay, this font is, I don't know how this A is looking. Let's try Milky Brush. That is a good font. Okay, that is not looking good. So again, I'm going to use my Explorer font here, as Explorer script. That is good for me. So let's overlap our two text here. Then I'm going to select the two text. Okay guys, sorry for that. I need to fill the area here. Okay, let's change the font here. Adventure is calling, so that is going to be the font. I wanted to make some swoosh kind of design, but as our main design is in kind of portal looking font, this is really important guys. When we are making a design, like if your main design is in this bolder kind of look and you make something in script kind of look, your client will maybe not like that design because he like this style. That's why he is giving you this option to use. And if you are making a scripted like font, that will not, maybe that will not impress him or her. So keep in mind that guys, whenever we are making designs. So let's break the font here. I'm just adding some random text here. I will add some more text later, or maybe I will think of some good text that goes with the adventure niche. Then I am going to add two ellipses like this, select these three, align them, then distribute the space between them, make them a group. So that is good. Then select this one, align together, then select this one, align together. So everything, okay, I cannot, sorry for that. As you can see, once we make changes on this one, it is making change on the final graphics. So let's press Ctrl Z for go back. Once our design is placed, we need to keep a group. We need to make them a group like this. That is good. Then select these three, align them center wise like this, no problem. So maybe this one like this, like that. Okay, I can simply select my this tree here to make it a, like make this one a bit bigger in size, because okay, sorry for that. That is not going to look very good. So let's use some colors for our text here. Maybe for that one, that color, and this one I'm going to use again this yellow color. So this is the final design for us guys. Let's see how it is looking on black color, and then we will know that if this is a look, good looking design or not. Cut, paste in back. Okay guys, as you can see, this is how our design is right now looking. And as you can see, here is some problem. We can see this part is matching with our design, but this part is not. So for fixing that, I need to first of all select my this two tree here, just two tree here, make a offset path for them just like this. 15 point is good for me. Okay, I don't know why my videos always take lots of time, so that is good for me. Press OK. Now I need to cut this, Ctrl X. Okay, once that is in my clipboard, I need to select this two mountain group here, this mountain group. Then inside the transparency, press Ctrl F to paste in front, and then we need to make it black. As you can see, when it is in black, it is making this area complete transparent. And then there is some extra part of the mountain is visible from here. So let's use our pencil tool. When the fill is black, just simply draw a shape here. That part will be invisible, and that is how it is going to look like a professional work. And everything here is looking Great, I think so. If that is your original design or anyone's or your client work, then I think this one, he is also going to like this one, because this is kind of similar but better version of this one, and this kind of design always looks good on, like, always looks good with textures. So let's use some texture here. I don't know which one I will use. Okay, let's use anyone. So I gave you some grand texture, so let's use one of them. So maybe this one here I am going to use, copy this one. And the way of using grand texture in our design is, first of all, you need to make everything a group, not this black rectangle. So press shift for clicking here, then whatever our design is. Okay, before that, maybe I think this one should be a bit bigger in size, because there are some, sometimes we need to fix it manually by looking at our designs, because the proportions are not always good for Illustrator. They use some measurements. So I think this is looking good for me. Now I need to select them all except this black background. So make them a group, make everything a group, just like this. Then select this group, open the transparency. And this is the easiest way of applying grand texture on your design, because that is not going to cut your design or make your design erase any part of your design. So paste the texture here inside the transparency, then maybe make it a bit smaller in size, whatever you feel right, something like this. Then press Ctrl D to make another copy there, and once that is placed in the position, okay, you need to select them. Then I'm going to make another copy here. Then maybe I will make it bigger in size so that it covers my calling area. Adventure is calling text, just like this. So this is the final design, guys. I hope this one will give you some idea, guys, how to work with this kind of designs, or how to extract color from a design, then modify an idea or an existing design, how to make a better version of a existing design. So whoever is working on Fiverr, Upwork, you will get a lots of work like this to making a existing design better. So thank you, everyone. See you in the next video, guys. Have a great time.